Hi everyone, welcome back to the another video of Neuroness Academy. So guys, over here in this video we are going to learn the another new thermodynamic cycle, that is nothing but the Erikson cycle. So basically this particular Erikson cycle is modified and introduced by Mr. John Erikson in 1940. He was the man behind the modification of the heat engine, and in 1940 he made a particular heat engine which works on this particular Erikson cycle, and he implemented that particular Erikson cycle into to move a ship, basically into a engine of a ship. So guys, basically this particular Erikson cycle is a slight modification of the previous Brayton cycle. In case of Brayton cycle, it works on the two isentropic compression as well as isentropic expansion. But over here, this particular Erikson cycle, it works on isothermal compression as well as isothermal expansion. So guys, that is nothing but the slight difference between this particular Brayton cycle and Erikson cycle. So guys, over here in this video we are going to learn about the Erikson cycle. It's what are the processes which is there in Erikson cycle and its work done and applications, as well as we'll talk about the efficiency as well. So guys, if you are new to my educational channel over here, you can subscribe it, and guys, please press the bell icon. So guys, without wasting any time, let's begin our today's topic, that is nothing but the Erikson cycle. So guys, in our previous video, we have seen the Stirling cycle, Stirling engine. Basically, this particular Stirling cycle consists of four different types of thermodynamic processes. That is nothing but the process 1 to 2 will be the isothermal expansion, followed by the constant volume cooling process, then isothermal compression, followed by the constant volume heating process. So now, over here in case of Stirling cycle, this is having the two types of constant volume heating and constant volume cooling process. So now, this particular constant volume process, what if we consider pressure as a constant? So guys, in the Erikson cycle, we have considered the pressure as a constant. So that is the slight modification from Carnot cycle to Erikson cycle. We have kept the pressure constant. So over here, in case of Erikson cycle, the total, there are the four thermodynamic processes, which is same as that of the Carnot cycle or as Stirling cycle. But the slight modification is we have kept pressure constant over here. So guys, these are the four thermodynamic processes, as we can say, we can see over here. The process 1 to 2 will be the isothermal expansion. The piston moves away after the combustion. The expansion will occur, the volume will increases, but over here the isothermal is used. The isothermal is nothing but the temperature remains constant over here. The total expansion will occur, pressure gets released over here, but there will be the slight increase in the entropy. As the, you know, as the volume increases, your entropy will also increase. The randomness inside the air molecules will also increase. So guys, in this particular Erikson cycle, the working media will be air. So that's why, you know, the randomness is more over here. The randomness will increase, the entropy also increase over here. So guys, that is nothing but the process 1 to 2, that will be the your isothermal expansion. So after the isothermal expansion, the constant pressure cooling will occur. So it means the heat gets rejected from your combustion chamber to the outer atmosphere. So guys, over here the constant pressure cooling will occur. It means the temperature falls down. Earlier it was having constant temperature, but right away after the expansion, the temperature will falls down, but the pressure will remains constant and the volume will reduce. The piston moves towards the compression. But guys, this particular process 2 to 3 is, you know, is a kind of reversible process. It is kind of a constant pressure reversible process. And guys, at this particular process 2 to 3, the volume gets reduced, okay, by keeping the pressure constant. So now moving ahead, that is nothing but the next process, that is nothing but the process 3 to 4 will be your isothermal compression. So guys, over here in this case of isothermal compression, the again temperature will remain constant. The piston moves towards the combustion point, basically, or towards the heat source. So at this particular point, the volume also reduces, the pressure starts increasing. So you will get a curve over here in PV diagram. Also guys, this particular process is the isothermal compression. The temperature remains constant, as you can see over here in TS diagram. that entropy reduces over here. As the volume gets reduced, the entropy, the randomness of the system will reduce over here. So by keeping the temperature constant. So guys, that is nothing but the process 3 to 4. And the next is the process 4 to 1. In the next process, that is process 4 to 1, the pressure will again becomes constant, as the ignition will occur at the constant pressure. 4 to 1 is the constant pressure heating process. So over here you can see on the TS diagram, the temperature goes up, okay, by keeping the pressure constant over here. So these are nothing but the 4 thermodynamic processes which consist of this particular Erikson cycle. So let's recall all this. The process 1 to 2 is nothing but the isothermal expansion, followed by the constant pressure cooling, then again isothermal compression, followed by constant pressure heating process. So guys, over here we can say that the heat gets added between the process 4 to 1 and heat gets rejected between process 2 to 3. But as we have seen in our previous Stirling engine, the heat gets added and heat gets rejected during the constant volume processes is the same. So over here the same term applies. It means over here the heat addition during the constant pressure process and the heat rejected during the constant pressure process will be the same. The total heat added and total heat rejected during this particular constant pressure heating and constant pressure cooling process will be the same. So that's why while doing the necessary calculation, we only take the total work done during the isothermal expansion and isothermal compression process. So guys, now let's move towards the calculation part. So at process 1 to 2, that is even the isothermal expansion, we can calculate the total work done by using the same formula that we have used in Carnot engine, Carnot cycle and Stirling cycle. That will be your 2.3 into m, that is the mass of the air, into engine cylinder, into r, that is gas constant, into T1 initial temperature, into V2 by V1, into log V2 by V1. So the for V2 by V1 over here will be the expansion ratio, and we can denote this particular expansion ratio by using the small letter r. So the total formula becomes 2.3 into mr T1 into log r. So that is the total work done during the process 1 to 2. Moving ahead, next is the 3 to 4, that is the constant pressure cooling process. So guys, as over here the pressure is constant, so that's why the Cp of that particular gas, that is the specific heat at constant pressure, will be used. So the total work done, or we can call it as the total heat rejected towards the atmosphere, by using the formula, that is mcp delta t. So m is the mass of the air, cp is the specific heat at constant pressure, and delta t. So guys, over here the t, this is the work done during the process 2 to 3. So over here the t2 minus t3, so that will be the formula to calculate the total work done during the process of 2 to 3, that is nothing but the constant pressure cooling process, or we can call it as the isobaric cooling process. So guys, moving ahead, next is the isothermal compression. So this is the same, the formula to calculate the total work done during the process of the isothermal compression will be the same. So that is, that will be your 2.3 into mr T3 into log V3 by V4. So guys, over here the V3 by V4 will be the compression ratio over here. So guys, we can this particular compression ratio can be denoted by using the small letter r. And we can modify that particular formula, that is 2.3 into mr into T3 into log r. So that is nothing but the formula to calculate the total work done during the process of 3 to 4, that is nothing but the isothermal compression process. So moving ahead, next is the process 4 to 1. So process 4 to 1 is the constant pressure heat added into the system, that is constant pressure heat supplied. So guys, over here in this particular process, the heats gets added into the system. So guys, we can calculate this particular heat supplied during the process 4 to 1 by using the formula of m into cp into delta t. That is nothing but the mcp into T1 minus T4. That is the formula to calculate the total heat supplied at constant pressure into the engine cylinder. So guys, the heat gets supplied during the process 4 to 1 and heat gets rejected during the process of 2 to 3. So this particular heat supplied and heat rejected will be the same. So that's why while doing the lot of calculations, we don't consider the heat supplied and heat rejected during this constant pressure processes. So guys, now let's talk about the total work done and efficiency of this particular Ericsson cycle. So total work done will be the same as that of the Stirling cycle or else the Carnot cycle. That will be total your heat supplied minus heat rejected. If we equate all the formulas that we have got over here during the process 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, we can calculate the total work done over here. So which will be the same as that of the Stirling cycle. Also the efficiency of Ericsson cycle is also the same as that of the Stirling cycle. So guys, this particular Ericsson cycle is the ideal one, and we cannot implement that particular cycle into the four-stroke piston cylinder engine. We can implement that particular cycle into the turbine engine. So that's why this is like Brayton cycle, and this particular Ericsson cycle, it is used in the turbine-driven engines. So guys, that was all about the Ericsson cycle. If you're having any doubts, any queries, guys, please, you can leave a comment below. And guys, please do subscribe to my educational channel, Engineers Academy, guys. So guys, thanks for watching my educational video. Please do subscribe to my educational channel, Engineers Academy.